meet everybody. See? Look, this is my little Scotty. Ah! Stop eating me. This is Scotty. She's my baby. Isn't she pretty? Isn't she pretty? She can see herself in the camera. Okay. Okay. Yeah. You're a cutie pie. You're a cutie pie. She's 10 weeks old. She's an Aussie Shepherd cross miniature poodle. Aussie Doodle, that's what they call her. We got her nearly 2 weeks ago. Ah! Stop it! Yeah. Should I put you down now? I don't want to. You're so cute. Yeah, she's a terror. She's not a terror. She's gorgeous. She's such a sweetie pie. She's so cute. Like, you just can't be unhappy when she's around. Unless she just pooped on the floor and you've got to clean it up. she's so gorgeous. I love her. She's been taking up a lot of my time. Just, I don't know, puppies take looking after. But my God, she's worth it. She just makes you happy. Hey, stop that. She likes playing with my stitching stuff. And I don't like her doing that. Okay. So, how have you all been? I'm Tash the Starcross Stitcher, by the way. I didn't introduce myself because I was so busy introducing you to Skadi. Oh, Skadi, S-K-A-D-I. She is named after the Norse goddess of hunting and archery and cross-country skiing. And the goddess Skadi has a giant wolf. I think the wolf is called Kaldo. But we thought the wolf was called Skadi, so we thought we were being really clever and naming her after the wolf, but no. She's eating my socks and like, ow! Biting my thumb. Ow! And crawling around near my feet. She likes to sleep. I'm sitting on my swivel chair, my desk chair. She likes to sleep, like curl up in between like the spokes on the bottom of the chair. She likes to curl up there and sleep. So I can't like roll it away. She's gorgeous. She's so cute. I love her. And now she's playing like crazy with her rope. Anyway, enough dog talk. There's never enough dog talk, is there? Never enough. Let's talk about stitching, because that's what you're all here for. Please indulge me a little bit of puppy talk. So, I'm going to start off with a wonderful gift I got. Wonderful gift. Actually, I mean, it's just a bunch of crap, according to Lindsay. Lindsay sent me a cool postcard. She wrote me a nice note, and she got me all this amazing stuff. Bunch of ribbons. I love pink and green and red and green. I'm obsessed with deep red used to be my favorite color. Now my favorite color is like really yellowy greens, just like this. Love it. Wonder if I could do something with like a burgundy red and a yellowy green. How all those colors go together? Don't know. So I have a bunch of ribbon. I have no idea what I'll do with that. I'll have to get my creative finishing on. I've lost a thread. She sent me three beautiful, beautiful, beautiful threads. This one is Jodi Ree Designs, color 204R, Chinese Moon Moth. Chinese Moon Moth. Love it. Again, that pink and green. Love it. Pink and green. This is Fibalicious Gothic Princess. How pretty is that? Love it. Oh my gosh. The other one, where is it? It's like blue and purple. Hey, stop. I'd like her to go to sleep right now. That would be good. I've never used Jodi Ree or Fibalicious, so they're fun. Fun things to play with. Yay. She sent me a soap. Dark Carnival Traditional Handmade Soap. Future Primitive Soap Company. And it smells really weird. Honeycomb drizzled with warm caramel sauce, hot sugared walnuts, fresh coconuts from the Shy, and a velvet pouch filled with nuggets of amber and tonka bean. Whatever tonka bean is. What are you doing down there? Okay. She also sent me some finishing fabric with irons on it. I think I'm going to make this into a groin guard because it's like cute. It's so cute. I love polka dots. Anything with polka dots, I'm in love with. I've got a daylight light right here, and it's really good until I get too close, and then everything just washes out. So, Yep. And she sent me a beautiful chart. Love, Rose with Anna. Live each season. Live each season as it passes. Breathe the air, drink the drink, taste the fruit, and resign yourself to the influences of each. It's beautiful. Love this. Love this. Thank you, Lindsay. She also sent me a piece of fabric, which I'll show you in a little while. And the reason she said this is because she made me a project bag. A project bag. It's so pretty. Look, it's got a little snowflake thing on the thing. And it's lined on the inside. And it's so beautifully made. Like, I'm not a sewer. I don't really know what beautifully made means, but it looks beautiful to me. It looks absolutely perfect. And I love this fabric. And I love this fabric. I think this is meant to be reindeer. But when I saw it, all I could think was, those aren't reindeer. They are butt plugs with antlers, aren't they? They are. I mean, look at it. You can't unsee that, right? So I had to have this. I bought this from her Facebook page. She makes and sells project bags. I can't remember the name of her page, but I will post it right here. I'm really, really sorry I can't remember, but they are beautiful. They are so nice. I haven't even used it yet because I wanted to show you first, but I should have used it. I should have actually used it for the thing I finished. This is the fabric that Lindsay sent me, okay? It's XG Designs Jack-O-Lantern, 40 count. Love 40 count. She knows me. And I actually used it the day I got it, or the day after I got it, and I had a finish. Yay! Isn't that cute? It's so cute. I think this is adorable. This is Tomb Sweet Tomb by Fairy Wool in the Wood, and it's beautiful. Isn't it so cute? Yeah, this is a pattern that I bought on Etsy, Fairy Wool in the Wood. The designer is in Italy, her name's Sandy. She's really nice. I think the designs are just so cute. They're so quirky and weird. There's ones that are like, there's one about a radish ghost, like the farmer is, or is it a rabbit, pulling up the radishes from the garden, and the little ghosts are flying away. I love the Baba Yaga one. There's a really beautiful unicorn on a bag. They're just so cute. And this, I just thought, you know what? It's so romantic in a macabre sort of way. You know, even after death, we'll still be together. It's so cute. Tomb Sweet Tomb. I love it. And I love this fabric. Lindsay, thank you so much for the fabric, for the bag, for everything. You're so generous. Lindsay and I are sort of postcard pals. I've decided, kind of postcard pals. So now I'm going to get together some amazing stuff and send it to her. God, I love this fabric. Yeah, and I just used a tiny bit of it for this Tomb Sweet Tomb. Love it. I think I might make this probably into a cushion because that's how the model looked on the webpage. Anyway, go and also check out Fairy Wool in the Wood. I'll put the name of the shop up here on Etsy. She has so many cute things. Okay, and I also got crinkle crinkle. Sorry, I know some people don't like that. I also got my, I think this is January fabric of the month from Under the Sea Fabrics. This is Winter Sunset 32 count linen. There we go. Very pretty. It's looking a little brown here, but actually in real life it looks sort of orangey pink. Don't know why it looks brown on the screen. Yeah, sort of some of this light lilac-y colour here. It's basically just pink and lilac and a bit of orangey pink. It's very pretty. Again, don't know what I'll use it for. I'll find something. I'll use it one day. I really enjoy getting a fabric of the month. I also signed up for XG Designs fabric of the month, and I know that she sent January on the 15th of January. And it's now the 25th of February, and I still haven't received it. I'm starting to panic a little bit. It is slow to get post in Australia, especially from Hungary. but I've ordered from her before, and it hasn't been that slow. So I am a little worried, I'm not going to lie. I might wait a week and then write to Jukas. Because I think she would have said February's by now, and I still haven't received January's. Not, I mean, once it leaves her, it's out of her control, I guess, but, you know. Anyway, so I did the Stitch Mania Winter Olympics Stitch Along this month, which was like basically stitch on a different piece each day. And it was hard. It was really tough. I find that challenging to change every day. I sort of feel like I'm not getting enough progress on anything. So I've got a lot of different things to show you, but not a lot of progress on any of them. I skipped one or two days just because it was too hard. I told you about the plans of what I was going to stitch on each day last month, or in my last video at least, and I didn't follow those every day. I chose something else that would fit the theme that I actually felt like working on. So I'll just show you what I've worked on. So you might remember this one. This is a 40 count silk gauze kit. It's a bit washed out, sorry. Called Gaze a While. There you go. You might be able to see it a bit better there. Gaze a While. I feel like the iPad video is not as good quality as my phone video. My phone is... It's dead. It is dead. I'm getting a new one as soon as possible, I hope. But I've been saying that for a month now. So Gaze a While. That's another reason why I haven't been making videos, because the iPad I'm not happy with and the phone isn't working. This is Gaze a While. Gaze a While by The Heart's Content. It's 40 count silk gauze and it uses a Vereswar silk. You can see them all there. Don't mind the pattern. I worked on this for a couple of days of the stitch along, and here is where I'm up to. I've completed nearly all of the little motifs in the sky. Here I have to do, you can see the owl's face there and part of his wing. I have to finish off the owl's face and wing, and then the tree that he's sitting in, and then the girl is here, and then I can fill in the sky. There's obviously motifs and words, gaze a while, gaze a while, words on the bottom, and then I can fill in the grass. So I actually feel like I'm getting somewhere with this. I think I'll finish this pretty soon. I mean pretty soon, hopefully before Mania. Basically my goal from this point on is to finish as many things as possible before Mania. If you remember last year what I did for Mania, and what I'll do this year as well, is work on a different piece every day. I know, I just said I hate doing that. but that's what I'm going to do. Work on one of my whips every day. So, and I'll also vlog it. So every single day, basically over the whole month of Mania, you'll see my whip parade because you'll see all of my whips. What I want to do is finish as many pieces as possible before Mania so that I have a few spare days where I can have new starts. Because I have like 25 or something things I want to start, and all of them I want to start desperately. Absolutely desperately. And that's just not possible. I mean, it is possible, but I'm not doing it to myself. So what else have I worked on? You saw my finish? Okay. Obviously I did a little bit of work on Tranquility Sampler. Let me take this off so you can see a bit better. This is by Stickadin von der Weinberg. Don't know if I'm saying that correctly at all. I don't know where you saw this last. You probably didn't see this, and this. Second half of this. Yeah, it's coming along. I'm trying to do one motif each weekend. But that is challenging because the motifs are huge. They take a long time. I mean, it looks small, but it takes a really long time. Like this took me like 5 hours, which is like almost a whole weekend day of stitching for me. And my other weekend work is two motifs a day on and a forest grew. And if I've got a big tree on and a forest grew and a big motif on here, it's really difficult. But it's beautiful. I'm still loving it. I'm having trouble with the fabric. It's 32, you can see the sparkles, 32 count opalescent. It's a Lugana, and it's from Silkweaver. I love Silkweaver fabrics. I won't hear anyone say a bad thing about them. Sometimes you have to be patient, people. So yeah, God, it's so pretty. But the problem I'm having with the fabric is that it's really dense. Like Yeah, it's really dense, the holes are very tiny. And it's not that I can't see it. The problem I'm having is that when I pull the thread through, it's actually damaging the thread. It might be because of the actual opalescent. I found before that opalescent fabric is like rougher on the thread. And I'm just having a big problem with this. It also doesn't help that I'm using Weeks Dye Works and Gentle Arts, and particularly the Weeks Dye Works, they are sort of weaker anyway. Like, I've had problems with them sort of falling apart just when I'm using them with a regular fabric. But yeah, over one on this fabric, it's quite tight. The holes are tiny. The opalescent fibre in the fabric is just rough. So it's a bit difficult to work on, honestly. But it looks so pretty, so I don't mind. It's okay. God, I'm looking desperately for places to put these things. Alright, I'll put it there. I'll do this one. Excuse me. I can't put things on the floor at the moment because of Scardy. She will destroy anything I put on the floor. I've done a bit of work on Wallace. Finished out this middle star. Oh, on the day when you had to do 15. The theme for the Winter Olympics was 15 because there are 15 new events or something. So each wheel of this star has 15 queen stitches or partial queen stitches. So I actually did 15 times 4. I think I did the 4 light blue ones in one day, and that was a lot for me. Then for the day that was 79, I thought to myself, maybe I can actually do 79 queen stitches because I did 60 in one day on here. So I was going to do 79 here and I didn't. then on the day that was do something you've never done before, I did this part here. This is all Roman stitch and you cannot see it. It's basically, each stitch is like one leg of a queen stitch, a middle leg, and it's just rows and rows and rows of them here. So that little block is now done and it took me like 20 minutes. it's the blank spaces here. Actually, there are blank spaces all over the place. Here, 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 in here, around these things, in here. All the blank spaces in this thing will be filled in with gold and silver metallic threads. Yeah, so that's the progress I've done on this. I'm hoping this month I am going to try to finish off those two pink. These two are both pink. Pink pinwheels. So we'll see. We will see. Maybe, maybe not. Next, I spent one day working on Fir Tree Mountain from the Cat's Whiskers Design Studio. This is out of print. The Cat's Whiskers are no longer in business, as far as I can tell. I've told you before about these. I made these two for friends of mine. I made this one for Veronica and this one for Tara. This was back when I used to work night shifts with them, and all three of us used to sit there and stitch together, and it was great. So I actually finished up this is the needle book, and I finished it. Tash, you got the year wrong, it's 2018. Yeah, I wrote 2007 because that was the year that we all sat together and stitched, and these are meant to be three things for three friends, and I always had planned to get them all done so we'd all have a matching set, and I just wanted them all to be the same. So this says 2007 even though it's 2018. I think it's very cute. I love the little houses. I think I might have stitched on this for the day that was stitch on something with houses. So, I love that. Okay. Don't mind me, I'm just rearranging. I'm running out of room here. Okay. I think for three or four days I worked on this. This is Japanese Octagon Box by Chatelaine. I know you've all seen it before. I love it. I worked on the mountain for the day that was stitch on something winter or snow themed. I came and worked on the mountain. The day that was work on metallics or beads, I worked on this border up here that's got metallics around the road stitches and metallics underneath. And also, well, there are beads here. I didn't do any beads, I don't think. I finished all the road stitches all the way along. I worked on these two lanterns, but I didn't quite finish them. I'm going to try really hard to finish this before Stitch Mania. This will be probably the only big thing I'll be able to finish before Stitch Mania, but I really want to. I love this. I love this. It's beautiful. In the Chatelaine sale, I bought two new Chatelaines. I bought, and I know I wasn't meant to buy any charts this year, but it was a sale. I had to. I'm doing it for Martina, right? In memory of Martina. So I bought the, I might have to put pictures up because I can't show you very easily. Bought the small Hammam Oasis. And I think that's the next one I'll start because I think that's gorgeous. And I also bought the, oh, what's it called? Amazing Marie Antoinette Kaleidoscope Rose Garden. I think that's what it's called. They're both gorgeous. There's someone on Instagram right now stitching the Marie Antoinette one. Oh my God, it's so beautiful. So beautiful. Anyway, so I bought those two, so I want to finish this. I'm not going to finish this into the box. I'm just going to leave it as a wall hanging, but I've decided I'm going to make a couple of little changes. So right here and here, I'm actually going to fill that in with slate blue, which is this blue here in these red stitches. Just to make that the bottom part a bit more solid. And then between the panels, I'm actually going to do a diagonal satin stitch just in this black silk. Diagonal satin stitch. Because I think then it will look like these are actually windows. Rather than now it just looks like a frame around. And you know, this part in the middle just looks a bit weird and empty. So I think that'll help the panel, the panels look solid. And it'll help the gaps between look filled in, so this actually recedes into the background. That's what I'm hoping anyway. I don't know why I want to add a lot more work to it will be a lot more work that I'm adding to this piece that I don't need to do, but I think it'll be worth it. I think it'll look really good. So that's my tentative plan. I'm currently waiting for this slate blue. It seems like it's not in stock anywhere, and I do have it on back order from 123 Stitch, but we'll see. Also, I remember before looking for this slate blue. Sorry, when it's too close to this light, it's really washed out. Looking for more of this slate blue, and every skein I could find was really grey. It wasn't this nice rich blue green. So that might be a problem I have when I get new skeins in. We shall see. Okay. I love that one. I worked on Fire and Ice. Let's put it behind me. Do I have something to put behind? There you go. No, that doesn't really work. Fire and Ice by Custom Crafts. That's beautiful. It's really beautiful. Basically what I did was I finished off this page, this part up here, more of the most of this main part, and then I came down onto this next page. This is huge and it's a ton of work and it's not the most fun stitching. This is my oldest whip. And what I had planned at the beginning of this month was, I'm going to work on this until it's done because I want my oldest whip finished, but I just can't. This is too, it's not fun to stitch. yeah, it's just confetti and, I mean, at least there's only like 12 colours in the whole thing. You know, half a dozen reds, half a dozen blues, but yeah. But I did work on this quite a lot this month, like maybe 20 hours. So it will get done eventually, it's just going to be slow. I would love to finish it this year. I would love to go into next year with, you know, all my whips from 2007 finished. Because this was from before 2007, this was from about 2004 or 5. So yeah, I'd love to finish this. It does look dramatic and amazing. Gosh, it looks terrible. It looks terrible when there's nothing behind it. Oh yeah, I also worked on this obviously for the Korean flag prompt for the stitch along, which was stitched on something relating to Korea, and one of the suggestions was the Korea flag, which is red, blue, white, and black. And guess what? This is red, blue, white, and black. So, yay! Fire and Ice. I mean, I don't feel that yay about it, but yay! Yay! Woohoo! Okay. Then of course, as always, I worked on Under Forest Grew. Don't know where you saw this last. I think I finished the tree, but I don't think I'd finished the bunnies, the bird, the mushrooms, the big tree. Yeah, anything over here. Don't know. Yep, this is gorgeous. I'm ready to move the Q-snap again, I think. I did tell you, I'm pretty sure, that I found a verse to stitch up here. So when I get to the top half, it might be the last thing I do will be doing the big tree and the verse inside, but yeah, love this. I feel like it's coming along, like I've finished a full quarter now and I love it. So, and a forest grew. Is that everything? No, that's not everything. So last Saturday, not yesterday, a week ago, I went to a class in Sydney. The Cruel Goblin does classes. They hire teachers to come in and teach a design. And I went to a class with Margaret Light. And it is the Tree of Life. It's cruel embroidery. I don't have a good picture of what the whole thing looks like. This is the picture that we were provided with. It's terrible. You can't see. It's really dark. You can't see any detail. You can see the composition. So that's what it looks like. I have this enormous piece of, I think it's linen toile we're stitching it on. And it's all marked out on here. I haven't started it really. Just working on a scrap piece of fabric. So I think this was on the day that was work on specialty stitches, and there are a lot of specialty stitches in cruel embroidery. So yeah, it's wool embroidery, so it's really coarse, and much coarser than what I'm used to. So aren't they amazing? Oh my god. These are all Gumnut Yarns blossoms. Lots of Appleton wools here. There are also a lot of, see these finer ones that look almost like pearls? I think they are, can't remember, I don't know. They're all wools, and some of them are wool silk blends. But they're gorgeous colours. So this is a 4-part class, and I'll be going up 3 more times for a full day of tuition on it. In the book we've got some much better pictures of how the sections look. All these mounds, the beautiful filling in on the mounds, so pretty. Details and the flowers. So I'll just show you a quick picture of all of these. Look at that. Gosh, these filling patterns are just so pretty. And the detail, I mean, even on leaves, that detail, it's amazing. So there you go. Even the stems of the branch, like, it'll take a long time to do that, but that red flower, not a huge fan of, and it's massive, but you know, the detail in this. That's all French knots. I think you do the center in stem stitch or something, and then you just do layers of French knots all the way around it. Good thing I like French knots, hey? Gosh, that's so pretty. We haven't gone up, this is the top half, we haven't touched anything in the top half. Basically, this lesson, we looked at all the stitches we need for not the mounds. We had a short discussion on long and short stitch for filling in the animals, but whatever. But basically all the stitches we need for the flowers, leaves, and trunks in the bottom half, which is these 2 pages. And then we haven't discussed anything in the top pages. So there's a monkey. So cute. And then a parrot. I'm really not showing this very well. I just didn't want to pull the pages out. This amazing leaf. I'll be really interested to know what filling in is here. Look how pretty, actually. Look how pretty this is. Oh, you just can't see properly. I'm really sorry. So pretty. Anyway, so that is the next weekend we go. Look at those leaves. Oh, so pretty. And this. Love it. I love this. It's so pretty. This is the same designer. If you remember last year, I went up in about August to do the Blackbird Needle Cakes, which I haven't worked on at all since I came back, and I should. That's a whip. This is not a whip, people. This is not a whip. I'm not counting it as a whip. I'm not starting it until I finish the Blackbird Needle Case. So this is Margaret Light. Margaret Light, 2009. You can't buy this pattern alone, she only teaches it. And she said, this is the swan song, this is the last time she's ever going to teach it. After this class, she's going to go and frame her original piece, and that's it. So, yeah. I'm really glad I got in on this, because it's so lovely. So, yeah, I did that. The next time I go is in May, so... yeah, what else? So, as I said, my plans, I'm just going to be basically focusing on finishing things. I'm going to finish this. I just started this morning as soon as I finished Tomb Sweet Tomb. Oh, it's the last day of the Winter Olympics challenge, and it was work on something that's close to finish. So I finished Tomb Sweet Tomb this morning. I'll work on this. This is Angle of Love by Cross-Eyed Cat. This is out of print. But if you're a bit of a nerd like me, you'll appreciate it. Is that my dog? She's snoring. Can you hear that? She's snoring. She stopped. Okay. Anyway, I'll finish this. This will be really quick. I want to finish it by the end of the month. Then I'm going to try and finish Gaze Awhile, the little Silk Gauze one. I'll try and finish Regal Peacocks, that little tiny Teresa Wenzel one I'm doing with the two peacocks. I'm going to try and finish Japanese Octagon Box before Mania, so probably at the very end of April. I'm going to try and finish... Oh, I have another sort of cruel... Stumpwork piece called Oak Tree by Jan Curtin. I'm not going to finish that, but I'm going to take the pieces I've done and make it into a needle minder and then turn the rest into a UFO. Because I practiced the techniques that I wanted to practice when I did that. It was a learning piece. I practiced the techniques. I can take what I did, turn it into a needle minder. I can make more if I want to in the future. But I don't need to just finish this whole big piece of an oak tree. Anyway, I shouldn't talk about that one. I don't have it with me to show you. But I will show you one day. So that's all. Is that all? I think that's all. I have a big, big order coming from 123 Stitch. Basically, I kitted up all the things I want to start. I'm not buying patterns this year, except for the ones I bought. I did buy some at the beginning of the year from Stitching Bits and Bobs, because my sister got me a very generous gift certificate from there. So I bought a ton of patterns there, and that doesn't count because it was a gift. And I'm hoping that not buying new patterns means that I won't spend as much money. So instead of spending money on that, I'm spending money on kitting things up. And I think that's good, because then if there comes a time when I can't spend money on stitching, I have plenty of things kitted up to start. So that's what I'm doing. Anyway, my dad's going over to the States on Tuesday or something, so he'll bring that order back, and I'm excited. I bought my mum an amazing present from Sajou of France. It was the kit for the... Oh God, what's it called? I might have to put what it's called up here and a picture. It's like a toile sampler, and it's got some Overcam fabric on it. And she got the whole kit, and she's really excited, and it's beautiful, and I'm super jealous. And good thing I'm going to Sajou in July. Yep. I'm definitely going to Sajou when I get to Paris. And I'm going to buy like probably $1,000 worth of stuff, because I want everything. okay, I'm going to stop talking now. I've been going for a long time. I know there was more stuff I wanted to say, but I just can't think what it was. I will try and come back before a month has passed. I'll try. I'm really sorry, guys. I've just been... not in the mood to make videos. I've been busy. I've been away 2 weekends this month. I've been looking after a new puppy. I'm just busy, and I'm not motivated to make videos so much, just because, I don't know why, just because. but I will try and come back, because I will have lots of finishes. I think I was kind of waiting for the end of this big stitch along, because the stitch along was really throwing me off. Doing a new thing every day is not great for me. Stressful, and a few days I came home and I just didn't want to stitch, and I really had to make myself, and a couple of days I didn't. Yeah, so I'll see you in March, I promise. Have a good stitchy weekend. It's already Sunday here, so your weekend's probably almost over. See you later. I'm saying goodbye now. Goodbye.